The internet connection speed and bandwidth have increased hundreds of times, from a maximum speed of 56 kilobits per second in 1993 to an average speed of tens or hundreds of megabits per second depending on the country where you are. And yet, sometimes it is very hard to get a proper internet connection. Now, why is that? The thing is that at the same time, the development of high-definition videos, the Internet of Things, online video games, cloud computing, and other services put higher requirements on the network. So how does the internet service provider answer the increasing demand? One of the solutions is optic fibers. So today we will talk briefly about types of optic fibers, their connectors, how they work, what we have for you in our offer, and a new special option that is available only for our customers. You can check the timestamps in the description. But before we jump into the world of optic fibers, hit the subscribe button so we won't miss any newly episode or new products. Unlike copper wires such as Ethernet or coax cables, which send data using electricity, optic fibers transmit data by light pulses using lasers or LEDs. There are four main parts of the fiber: core and cladding, which are made of extremely pure glass or plastic, also called silica; a buffer, which protects them from moisture and physical damages; and a jacket, which is a protective outer coating. In order to trap the light, also known as total internal reflection, the refractive index of the core has to be higher than of its cladding. In comparison to copper wires, fibers have much higher bandwidth, transmission speeds, lower attenuation, and are immune to electromagnetic interferences. But there is a but. We do not live in an ideal world, and we are not able to remove completely the attenuation. So even in optic fibers, we need to use amplifiers. There are two types of fibers, multimode and single mode. The difference is in the dimensions of the core. For multimode, the core is usually 50 or 62.5 microns, slightly bigger than a human hair, whereas the single mode has a core of about 9 microns. By the way, every fiber with a core that is less than 10 microns is considered to be a single mode. The core of the single mode is so small that it allows only one ray or mode to enter. The source of the light pulses comes from lasers at wavelengths of 1310 and 1550 nanometers, which have very low losses and, if we can say, infinite bandwidth. Due to the wider core of the multimode, more than just one ray can enter, hence its name, multimode. But it's also its curse because of the dispersion, allowing it only to go as far as 2 to 3 kilometers. The pulse sources are LEDs at wavelengths of 850 and 1300 nanometers. Now, I know that you think that optic fibers are extremely fragile and a small band will reduce the transmission speed or even cause a signal loss. But according to a very famous manufacturer of optic fibers, its ultra-pure glass is actually quite flexible and 3 times stronger than steel and 6 times stronger than titanium. The single mode and multimode that we mentioned so far are made of glass and can be referred as GOF, glass optic fibers. Another version that we have here is POF, polymer optic fibers. This type of fiber has a much larger core cladding dimensions and therefore can reach only 100 meters and has very low data rates. The biggest advantage is cost. It can replace a few Ethernet cables category 6E with ease, and because it's made of plastic, the cable itself is more rugged and can withstand tighter bends radius than glass optic fibers. Moreover, there is a cost advantage for actual installation time. It's an eye-safe equipment and requires less power, as well as no crosstalk if installed next to electric wires. We cannot talk about fibers and not to mention their connectors. Those connectors allow you to connect and disconnect your fiber from one port to another many, many times. The most common ones are ST, FC, SC, E2000 and LC. ST stands for straight tip, a high-performance fiber optic connector with round ceramic ferrules and bayonet locking features, usually used in AV equipment. The FC stands for ferrule connector and is mostly used in datacom, telecom and measurement equipment and single-mode lasers. The SC stands for subscriber connector and it is a standard duplex fiber optic connector with a rectangular cross-section for industry and automation, also used in telecommunication and other solutions necessary for construction of optic fiber networks. The LC stands for LUCENT connector, no, actually LUCENT corporation. It didn't work at the beginning because of the high license fees, but its small size and large features makes it ideal for densely populated racks or panels. Each of the connectors come in two different variants, UPC and APC. Ultra-polished connectors and angle-polished connectors. The difference between them is in the angle of polishing of the ferrule. With the UPC, the ferrule is flat, 0 degrees, while with the angled, the angle of polishing is at 8 degrees to reduce the reflection. By the way, if you need more information about connectors, you can check our other video about connectors here. But don't click it just yet, you will miss the most interesting part. So enough with the small talk and let's get to business. In the TME offer, you will find optical fibers from manufacturers such as LAPP, FIBRAIN, LOGILINK, QOLTEC and others. FIBRAIN fibers are manufactured in versions that include sheets that are resistant to low and high temperatures, UV radiations, water or mechanical damage. Their diameters range from 3.0 to 10.1 mm and their typical applications are LAN and FTTX networks such as broadband telecommunication systems, telephony or television. Those fibers are available in sections of 100 meters or longer with multiples of 100. Plastic optical fibers offered by LAPP are the Heatronic series cables, available in simplex and duplex versions. The series is used mainly in industry and whenever it is required to secure data transmission in difficult conditions such as high temperature or explosion hazard zones. Heatronic optical fibers can be installed both inside and outside of the building. The series includes standard and special versions such as optical fibers with halogen-free and oil-resistant sheath, which also withstand abrasion, microbial action and hydrolysis, as well as optical fibers for applications in moving connections. Typical lengths are 5, 25, 50 and 100 meters. The LAPP fiber optic connectors offer includes POF HFBR, which comes in simplex and duplex for 2.2 mm cables, POF FO5, which have a snap-in system, comes in simplex version for 2.2 mm cables. Next, we have the POF FSMA and ST connectors suitable for 2.2 or 6 mm cables. The POF SCRJ connectors are suitable for 2.2 mm cables. They come with SC connectors, SCRJ housing and two anti-kick and dust covers. It is also worth mentioning the range of LAPP accessories, which includes a series of tools for cutting strands and stripping cables for various diameters, kits for assembling POF crimp connectors, as well as polishing discs and foils with different grain sizes. In the case of FIBRAIN connectors, customer can choose between SC, FC, ST, LC, and E2000 connectors in APC and UPC versions. In our offer, you will also find patch cords and pigtails. The LAPP offer includes both in lengths of 2 meters. FIBRAIN patch cords can be found from a half a meter up to 30 meters, while FIBRAIN pigtails range from 1 to 2 meters. From FIBRAIN accessories, we have the OSC, an OTDR starter cube. It comes with different types of connectors for multimode and single mode fibers. The cube has compact housing made of sturdy construction that is resistant to mechanical damages. It includes magnetic mounting, a shoulder strap, and a color code for easy identification. Ladies and gentlemen, from now on, you don't have to buy the full drum. You can buy a half of it or half of the half. And all this thanks to Mora. The device is designed to rewind electrical and optical cables from one drum to another up to 2.5 tons. The rewinding machine is equipped with a laser sight and microprocessor management system that ensures optimal pressure, accurate positioning of the cable, and control of the rewinding speed, which can reach up to 70 RPM. This is a big deal for the safety of our employees, but even a bigger deal for you. Thanks to all the sensors that Mora has, it can rewind and cut glass optic fibers without damaging it or breaking it in any way. Moreover, it gives you the convenience of making smaller purchases. To see our full offer of optic fiber cables, go to our website TMEEU. If you need more information or you have a question, comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and thank you for watching.